December 20th, 2009. We're not just on the radio. We're also simulcasting via web television at prisonplanet.tv. And for folks watching us, we can zoom in on the document cam right here. Australia to implement mandatory internet censorship. October 29th, 2008. This is just the first thing we pulled up when we Googled Australia Chinese-style censorship. They have since implemented this last week. This is now in force. This is an article from a year ago, a year and 2 months. Okay, here's another one. Australia to enforce mandatory Chinese-style internet censorship. There's another headline. Okay, so that is the reality. And I got a caller calling in who disagrees with me and thinks I'm just making that up. Have you not heard that Canada and England are announcing that they are going to put the same system in? You won't be able to get Infowars.com and PrisonPlanet.com. We are in these databases. We are blocked. Their government says it will be politically incorrect information in Australia that's blocked. They're in the process of blocking our sites. We're already blocked on government wireless networks they, quote, give to the public free, the taxpayers paid for. This is already going on. Stop living in denial. Okay? I know it's hard to believe this is happening, but it is going on. Paul in England, you're on the air. Thanks for holding.
Hey, Alex.
Hey, buddy.
How you doing? Listen, I know you've been talking about Copenhagen a lot today, but my question is a more general question. I've kind of like got my eyes open to this recently, been watching things like Zeitgeist and the Fall of the Republic and the Obama deception. And what I don't understand is I know that Ben Bernanke was appointed under the Bush administration. Is that correct?
Yes.
Correct, yeah?
Yes.
And then he's been reappointed under Obama for another 4 years, correct?
Yes.
Right, but what I don't understand is, I don't understand how the president and the government is appointing these guys when the Federal Reserve is a private company.
Let me explain. The board represents a private consortium of banks, and the Federal Reserve is in the White Pages under business, chartered in 1913. Now, by an act of Congress. Now, the chairman of the Fed is appointed by the president. And then the Congress has to approve them. The Senate has to approve them, to be specific. Just like previously, high-level officers had to be approved by the Congress. More and more, they just forego that.
So it has to be. Is that because of the Federal Reserve Act in 1913 that ties them up that way?
Yes. That's why some people call it a quasi-governmental. But it doesn't matter because look at Nixon on up to Obama today. They have all been complete servants of the Federal Reserve. And if you look at their cabinets, if you look at who they appoint to Treasury Secretary, it's a revolving door of private shareholders of the Federal Reserve. That's like Goldman Sachs and J.P. Morgan have more than half of the federal regulators and more than that number, the vast majority of high-level people in government are former CEOs, former vice presidents, former presidents. And so it's a revolving door of bankers running the government.
Right, okay. I think I understand more now, yeah. And he was also, I noticed yesterday, he was voted Time Magazine Man of the Year.
Very sick, Paul. Good to hear from you. I appreciate your call. Let's talk to Jesse in Alabama. Jesse, you're on the air.
Hello, Alex. How are you doing? God bless you for the work you're doing, and I've turned hundreds of people onto your program. What I want to know is, in this Obamacare legislation, what kind of anti-gun legislation is he going to be trying to pass as far as diagnoses, and when is he going to try to implement these? Are these going to be in part of that bill, and what other anti-gun legislation is coming down the pike? Can you tell me?
Okay, I'm going to let you go and answer that question, Jesse. That's a big question. Here's the problem. There have been more than 10 versions. I mean, last week I wanted to know the number of versions, and I wasn't sure, so I went and spent about 30 minutes. There's been more than 10 versions. And then the latest version the public's being told about is bad enough. 5 years in prison, $250,000 fines if you don't get insurance, taking part of your paycheck out on top of it, giving liability protection to insurance companies, HMOs, and hospitals, lowering the standard of care, cutting Medicare, cutting Medicaid, while raising taxes. See, more taxes, less service. But a lot of people are saying, is it in the bill because it's been in previous health care bills, to have gun control in there. No. There are a bunch of gun control bills that have been introduced in the last 11 months that Obama's been in office. Some of them are in committee. None of them have gotten out of committee. So there's not a big danger right now. Instead, how Obama's going after guns is the feds are financing states to pass anti-Second Amendment victim disarmament legislation. Schwarzenegger signed a bill, what, 2 months ago, where you've got a thumbprint and register to buy ammo in California now. Other states are implementing that as well, and it was all federally funded. In some cases, the UN comes in and gives money under UNIDIR. That's the name of their UN lobbying arm that does that. No, there isn't any gun control in the versions we've seen. I have articles here in my stack today on health care. I'm sure you've seen it on the news. I've seen it quite a few places myself where people are complaining they can't see the final version. We have this version they put out 2 weeks ago, and now they've got another version that they're making deals on in the Senate, and the Republican leadership hasn't even been allowed to see it. Kind of like the House version of the greenhouse gas taxes. Thousands of pages long. No one was allowed to see it until they went to a vote. And then the House voted to pass it. It's now in the Senate. No one was allowed to read it. And when we finally got it, it was worse than previous bills. I mean, to describe it took hours on air. Just federal inspections of your home, no due process. Arbitrary inspectors outside the courts can put multi-thousand-dollar fines per day on your home. Federal zoning laws, huge 20% plus taxes on all fossil fuels. I mean, just hundreds and hundreds of things. I cover it in my film Fall of the Republic. Just 10 or 15 or so, I don't have the number, a whole bunch of just the most horrible things. And I have clips of C-SPAN where after they passed it, it was read out in committee. So I have it directly from Congress. It's in the film. It's so horrible. I mean, I just wish that there was a way to stop this. The good news is we beat Copenhagen, I'd say 90% to put a dead reckoning number on it. But next hour, when we start the next hour, I'm going to get into exactly what's happening there. I'm reading here in the London Guardian today and the Telegraph exactly what I got from the treaty and exactly what I talked about in the video that I posted that I shot Friday, breaking it down. Now the UN is agreeing with my analysis. And I wish this wasn't the case, but this is not a complete victory for us, but we had a victory. But we have to be honest about the situation we're in so that we can defeat it.